Welcome and hello. Thanks for tuning into the English News Programme on SN TV. I'm Mohammed Allen here to update you with the latest stories making the headlines. These are the stories to come. Presidential Press Secretary issues a press release. Minister of Health provides a report to members of the House of Elders over achievements made by the ministry. Afghanistan enjoys peaceful presidential elections. President of Somaliland, Ahmed Mohamed Mahmoud Silanu, has issued a press release over the 33rd anniversary of SNM's struggle to reclaim the independence of Somaliland. President of Somaliland, Ahmed Mohamed Mahmoud Silanu, conveyed cables of congratulations to the veterans of SNM over the 6th of April, marking the SNM Veterans Day. President of Somaliland indicated that the struggle that the veterans had been in defending their country and ensuring to lead their people into a peaceful and prosperous future led the Somaliland citizens into living in impunity. President Ahmed Silanu reiterated SNM veterans are those worth commend for the way they ensured progress in Somaliland after announcing the reclamation of independence of Somaliland. The president prayed Allah to grant those SNM members who died in the struggle with peaceful abode and prayed Allah to grant the veterans with lasting affection by their own people, hoping them to remain in good health. The president hoped continued peace and progress for Somaliland. This press statement was released by the president's press secretary, Ahmed Salaban. Minister of Justice Hussein Ahmed Aidid attended an event focusing on making reforms to judicial services. The event had in attendance several dignitaries, including the Chief of Supreme Court. The event was focused on making reforms to the judiciary services to better develop services for the citizens. Attendees at the event emphasized the importance of making reforms to the judiciary services to ensure that every Somaliland citizen has access to justice and, in accordance with the law, every citizen is eligible to justice service at the national courts. Minister of Justice Hussein Ahmed Aidid, speaking at the event, reiterated the necessity of reforming the judiciary services. The minister stated that the Ministry of Justice prioritizes the justice system and the reforms due to be made to the judiciary services ought to enhance services being provided for the citizens. Chief of Supreme Court Yusuf Ismail Ali expressed hope that such a reform can ensure more progress in the justice institutions, enabling the citizens to access well-coordinated justice system. Other keynote speakers at the event collectively pointed at the necessity of such a reform on the national justice system. The Permanent Committee of the House of Elders held a session to discuss improvements made thus far by the Ministry of Health. Minister of Health Salaban Ahmed Isa was in attendance at the event to answer questions by members of the House of Elders. The Permanent Committee of the House of Elders held a session to discuss improvements made by the health sector. Minister of Health Salaban Ahmed Isa was in attendance at the event. Minister of Health Salaban Ahmed Isa, speaking on improvements made by the health sector, elaborated on the major steps taken by the Ministry of Health, from taking constant tours to several regions and districts throughout Somaliland to rehabilitating hospitals. The minister reiterated that more have been achieved since he took office as the Minister of Health, including capacity building public hospitals as well as allocating more funds to government subsidized hospitals throughout Somaliland to ensure that all citizens in urban and rural areas are able to receive adequate medical attention. Minister of Health Salaban Ahmed Isa, speaking on the quality of the imported medicines, stated that the Ministry of Health paid heed to the efforts involving the import of medicines with no quality and that no one and the criteria is able to import or supply medicines to the markets throughout Somaliland. Minister of Health Salaban Ahmed Isa, speaking on a doctor who has recently been refused permission to work in Somaliland, stated that the ministry had no involvement in this issue and that it is appropriate the individuals involved to stand question at the House. Minister of Aviation and Air Transport Mohamed Hashi Abdi informed the media about talks held between Somaliland and Somalia, which took place in Istanbul to discuss administration of aviation system. Minister of Aviation and Air Transport Mohamed Hashi Abdi stated that talks were held between the two nations which resulted in success. The minister stated that the talks were focused on the management of aviation system and that a joint committee designated by both governments can and will eventually be able to take responsibility towards managing the aviation system. Minister Mahmoud Hashi Abdi confirmed that a two-point memorandum came out from the meeting held in Istanbul, which was brokered by the Turkish government. The minister reiterated that Somaliland stands up for reclaiming the management system of its air, which has been under the control of the UN for more than 20 years. Minister of Aviation Mahmoud Hashi Abdi pointed out both governments will soon be designating a joint committee responsible for the management of aviation system, which is due to be based in Hargeisa. The minister also confirmed that the two-point memorandum will be raised at the two nations talks due to be held soon. The director of the Employees Department for the Ministry of Health, Isa Abdi, attended an event to end a training program for 20 doctors. The event was organized by the National Doctors Association. It was held for 20 doctors, ending a two-day training program. A lecturer participating in the two-day training program, Mohammed Ahmed Arebo, spoke at the event. He exhorted the doctors to further their knowledge and put what they learned in the training into practice. Director of Somaliland's Doctors Association, Yasin Haji, commended the efforts of the doctors who ended the training program, urging the doctors to apply their knowledge on ensuring to enhance the medical care being provided for the citizens. Chairman of Doctors Association, Abdirashid Hashi Abdi, urged the doctors ending the training session to keep up with the modern technology. One of the doctors who ended the training program spoke at the event and pledged that they will use their knowledge on improving the healthcare services they provide for the citizens. Director of Employees Department for the Ministry of Health, Isa Abdi, expressed the importance of providing doctors with such a training program to further their knowledge and better serve the citizens. You're still tuned into the English News Program on SLN TV, the only Somali-speaking channel with an English News Program. And now for the international headlines in detail. The high numbers and the peaceful process signal successful Afghan election. The number of security personnel seems to have done its job of halting the Taliban threat, especially around the Taliban stronghold of Kandahar province. Most are thrilled at the outcome, one resident in Kabul said. "We're so happy that yesterday's election took place in a peaceful environment." Afghanistan's wrecked terrain means it could take 6 weeks for the ballot boxes to be sorted. Observers are anxious about the new leader, who will be tasked with stemming escalating violence just as US troops prepare to leave. The new leader would also have to decide on a pact with Washington to keep up to 10,000 US troops on the ground. An Australian ship is investigating a signal in the sea in search for missing flight MH370. It comes soon after news that a Chinese ship, Haixin-01, detected pulses 24 hours apart within 2 kilometers of one another. The Australian search leader, Air Chief Marshal Angus Houston, said these are the most promising leads yet, but added that it could not yet be verified whether the signals could be from the missing Boeing 77's black box. When it is investigated, this third ping signal, Ocean Shield will join HMS Eco in investigating the Chinese detection zone. The British battleship was about 14 hours at the time of the press conference. Black boxes have a battery life of 30 days and 4 weeks on from the plane mysteriously disappearing times running out. That's it for this edition of the English News Program. Thank you very much for being with us. You can catch us at the same time tomorrow. Until then, take care and goodbye.